Second on the docket, Ashanti Good Good. This video is charged with setting the women's movement back about 300 years. Jurors should note that if you keep a 12-pack of beer in your hair, you might be a redneck.
It's time for that good, good with Ashanti.
The first shot of the video, we see Ashanti with an empty case of beer in her hair. What's going on?
She either looks like a recycling bin or a white trash Christmas tree.
You're like, no, I don't have a problem. You've got a case of beer in your hair, hon.
Honey, could you get me a beer? Yeah, just hold on.
Hey, baby. I got that good good. That's how I clean the house. What?
Her husband is Nelly.
I guess it's Nelly. I didn't recognize him without his Band-Aid. I never had a problem keeping one.
Okay, clearly she has never done housework before because that's not how you do it.
Who washes a floor with their ass in the air?
Oh, I get it. She's Nelly's maid.
Any woman that wears her rings over top of her disc gloves, okay, that's high class. Get that lady a beer can for her hair.
You know, this is a real throwback to like the 50s when women were just cleaning machines.
You like? Now imagine I'm washing a floor.
They were there to clean and then cook and wait for their man to get home and then he would have sex with her. It was a simpler time.
Side boobage! Side boobie alert!
There's the best side boob shot, maybe of all time. This is gonna fall out.
That shot has everything for a man. There's boobs, bacon, and eggs.
When I cook, it's not all like, oh, hey. I was cooking this for my brother, and I was like, shut up! This is what you get. And I wasn't in my panties.
Can you see this right here?
And I got a little heat splat. That's what you get. You get oil on your skin. Hi!
It's her saying, leave my man alone, bitches. I've got the good good. So leave my man alone. Okay.
You do realize that your husband is Nelly, right? He is not coming right home, okay?
You're cleaning the floor in the kitchen, and he's out front in the Cadillac, nailing your best friend, for sure.
He's totally, you can even hear him. Listen. I don't hear anything. If I can't hear it, it's not happening.
Have some shame, Nelly. Have some damn shame.
That's what happens when girls find out their man is cheating on them. They go into like hardcore cleaning fits, just out of denial. They're like, ha, everything's perfect. See, I don't know what them other girls be doing.
Nice. They be crying about they men because they always lose. Wow, I've never seen anyone go to these great lengths to find change in between the couch cushions.
This couch is a problem. I can't tell if it's f***ed up or if I'm using my couch at home completely wrong.
All I can think is, I'd eat that couch out.
She wearing red latex in the cereal aisles?
Ashanti has got to be the only woman ever to go shopping for Pringles and shit tickets. I mean, if that's what your man needs you to get, get out there, woman. Give him Pringles and tickets.
I find Ashanti guilty of making housework look awesome.
I wouldn't want to do my boyfriend every night, especially when I spent the whole day scrubbing the floors.
I'm gonna tie Nelly down and see if I can force him to love me.
I sentence Ashanti to clean my house, and I'm gonna give it to her good good.
Hi, Nelly.
She's not leaving. She's never leaving. She's not leaving.
Ashanti, sentenced to wake up and smell the cheating husband already. Next on Video on Trial.
Danity Kane, damaged. And yes, the name says it all.
The jurors have no interest in fixing Danity Kane's damaged heart.
Why do I have to fix you? What? You're so demanding.
I'm crazy.
And I'll find you.
Later on in the show.
Lil Wayne got money.
Oh, it's my favorite show, America's Dumbest Criminals.
The jurors just can't seem to take Lil Wayne seriously as a bank robber.
Lil Wayne's got a plan, and it seems to involve dressing up like a Fraggle and robbing a bank populated by video hoes.
This guy looks like a Whoopi Goldberg lost her tits.
The following program...